Now I'm gonna make the feeling sad. I'm gonna try to press harder with my white crayon and see if I can have it show through the paint. Let's see, sad. Looks like a sad brown. If you want to put drawings in these, you can for this lesson. I think I'm ready for my paint. So I went ahead very quickly, cleaned off my palette so I can pre-mix my paints over here. I'm gonna start with some purple. All right, you can see my white crayon showing through. So that once I put the paint down, they become visible. You can do stuff like this. And I'm gonna add some blue. I think the purple's a little too cherry. Add some blue to this. I recommend not using the black that comes in the paint set. We can create black very easily by mixing complementary colors together. So let me show you what I'm talking about. Over here, say I have blue. The complement of blue is orange. So if I add orange to blue, I should get a brown. And if I add a lot of orange to a lot of blue, I should get a start to approach black. So that's what I'm gonna do. So you can see it's making brown over here. I'm gonna really saturate it and start to make things start to look dark and brown. It's not that, so I actually don't have that much blue here. Let's see if I can add more blue to darken it up. Yeah. So a lot of blue and a lot of orange will start to approximate. Yep, looks, it's starting to look like black. If you don't have black, it's easy to make black. I'm gonna try the wet on wet again, so I'm gonna clean off my brush, get all the paint out. Some wet here. Some water here. Some water here. some paint. I think I'll add red. Well, see it disperse. I didn't mean to get this. I'm gonna flip this off with my. I could wet my paper towel if I want to get that out. Put a little water on it. I pour a lot. I messed up. So, got a bunch of red off there. More wet on wet up here. So I already had paint in my brush. That's okay, I'm gonna add even more red to it. So now all this water, I'm gonna touch it with a bunch of red paint. So I'm gonna put a whole bunch of paint on my brush. Just touch this, let it disperse. So you have to make sure you have enough water in there. Oh, it's down here. I'm gonna put some water, just straight up water in here. Purple. Oh, that was cool. It's fun to watch it spread out. So now I'm kind of following my original crayon lines, having them influence my paint strokes. When watercolor dries, it tends to dry lighter than it looks when it's wet. I want to darken up some of the dark areas. I want to make them even darker. So I'm going to add yellow to purple and see if it does the trick.